Welcome to Gulfstream Park. It is March 29th, 2015. Christina Bosnak is joined by Ron Nicoletti. And Ron, another...
We did it.
Yeah, another day in paradise. Beautiful day here today, weather-wise, a light breeze, sunny, warm. I believe it's going to be in the mid-70s, so the weather is perfect. Yesterday, we had such a tremendous day here, Ron. Florida Derby Day. What can I say? So much fun.
Record-breaking day. The place was jammed. It was so much fun. Everybody had big smiles on their faces. Congratulations to the Connections of Materiality. We'll get to that in a minute. But first, I want to tell you about the Rainbow Six guarantee that we have today. $500,000. And it's a 12-race car today, so races 7 to 12. $500,000 guaranteed in the jackpot pool. We also have a guarantee in the pick five of $50,000. That's races 8 through 12. And $100,000 in the late pick four today. As Christina mentioned, a beautiful day. Fast main track, firm turf course. 12 exciting races. And as we said, what a day yesterday. It was lots of fun.
It was lots of fun. And we'll just take a quick look back at some of the events of yesterday. And we'll kick off with the Gulfstream Park Oaks. And Ron, really funny after the race. We'll have a look as we're talking about it here. I had chosen Eskin for Money. She's there. She's in there on the inside from the Todd Fletcher barn, and that says Star Ladies. She ran a great race, but who comes back out on the outside again? Bird at the Wire. Funny incident, folks. Tammy Fox passes by us after the race, and she said, "Do you guys believe in her now?" It's true, because I tried to beat her for. I've used her, and I have not put her on top in each of the last couple of starts, but. This filly, she's the real deal.
If you got a chance to go on ExpressBet, or if you're here at the racetrack, go back and look at the race, the beginning of this race, the eight horse in there. She had a steady so much in that race and back. It looked like the jock almost lost his irons. She was just so ranked to run, but he got her outside. So not only did she won very, very impressively. And Tammy was right to give us a little shot, because I actually picked a third yesterday. So it was all in fun, but this horse, something special, you know. You can see this horse running in next out in Kentucky. Should be good.
Tammy Fox, one of the main cogs in the Dale Roman's machine. So that's why we have to give her a shout-out, because just a really, really good day, a great day for the barn. They've got a nice filly looking down to the classics for the ladies later on this season. It's going to be pretty exciting. But we also had a couple of other races, Ron, we want to talk about. And let's start with the Skip Away. And it was earlier on the card, and Ron, winner was Commissioner, but look who's down on the inside fighting every step of the way. Commissioner, for all of you just to remember, he finished second in the Belmont Stakes for Todd Fletcher. He's a very nice stallion prospect for Winstar, but look who's on the inside.
Sir Kiskiano, fought him right to the wire and everything. Sir Kiskiano now on the Peter Waldemar for the last couple of starts. Its last race, went out to California, showed some speed. What a game performance. That was an exciting race. You never really knew who was going to win until they hit the wire. Congratulations to the Connections of Commissioner Todd Fletcher, and I'm sure we'll be talking about him more as we go through this rewind.
Yes, well, Mr. Todd Fletcher had two races earlier on the card, and then the big one in race 14 was the Besselou Stables Florida Derby, and it was the match. I wasn't going to say rematch. It was the match between Materiality from the Todd Fletcher barn. Todd had two, actually, Materiality and It's a Knockout, and also Upstart. Upstart, who crossed the wire first in the Fountain of Youth. He was demoted to second behind It's a Knockout. But Materiality, Ron, only his third career start. He actually did something similar to what Constitution did for the Fletcher stable last year in winning in only his third career start.
Yeah, third career start. What I liked, we talked about it before we went on. You know, he's the only horse in the race that won at 9 furlongs before he came back. So he's got two victories in a row at that 9 furlong distance, but he's lightly raced. And you know the old thing that no two-year-old since 1852 has won the Kentucky Derby. We'll see if that happens there, because Todd, this horse is really nice, going to move on. on and head down the road and see how he works out. So it should be a pretty good, exciting spring and summer coming up with these horses that we saw run yesterday.
And Materiality campaigned by Alto Racing, and Todd Fletcher's done such a great job with him, and a really beautiful pedigree. He is by a Fleet Alex. A Fleet Alex, he's a classic winner himself. He won the Preakness, and also the mare, she's already produced a very nice graded stakes winner, My Miss Sophia. So that horse has so much going for him, and it looks like distance is going to be his thing as he goes down the road, as Ron said. Hopefully on to the classics for Materiality, and actually for Upstart, because that was a really nice performance.
Yeah, I mean, Upstart, you can't take anything away. That's too fantastic. This horse, Upstart, always runs his race. You know, he's had a little bit of trouble in the last two starts, but he's right there at the wire. He's really a nice horse, and I expect to see him, you know, in the spring classics, too. He'll move forward off those two performances here and run very well as they go through the spring and summer.
So we will look on into today's 12 race card, and we kick off with an 8,000 claiming event, and that is the first 7 furlongs on the main track. And Ron, my top selection, I went with number three, Be A Bull, Kirk Zadie, second last time out. But Ron, this gelding, he had some trouble in that latest race.
Yeah, he was looking to make amends. He got parked. He got checked at the 16th pole in that race. He finished second as the favorite at this level and distance. Kirk Zadie looking to make amends. I went the other way. We have our exact flip-flop. I went with the 7, Lure of the Saddle, moved to the Antonio Sanobon. Avita Claim is going to turn back to 7 furlongs today after finishing a second against Similar. That was going a mile. The barn, 20% with new claims. Paco Lopez, great day yesterday, coming back from a fall 2 days before, wins a couple of races yesterday, and he's back on his horse. Be A Bull for all the reasons you mentioned, and we both threw in number 5, Megalith, who was third behind Be A Bull last time out.
We look on to the second race on today's card. It's a maiden maiden special weight. 5 furlongs on the turf course. Couple of scratches, number 7 and number 10. And jockey change, number 2, and that is Corey Lannery. And this kicks off the early pick 4. And my top pick, I tried to take a little bit of a shot in here, Ron, with number 3, and that is Jealous Cat. This is a 4-year-old daughter of Tappet, he's okay with his first timers on the turf. Very versatile stallion. She's a full sister to Tappet. Tappet, she actually won second time out. Very nice graded stakes winner at about a mile. So she was a very nice filly, and a couple of nice works for this Tevis McCauley runner as well.
Well, I went with the 8 Smoke Signal, the daughter of Street Sense, debuting for trainer Christophe Clement. This horse has 10 workouts showing. Trainer Clement, he's only 16% with his debut turf runners. Adds Lasix, Julian Leperu. I just like the workout pattern there, so I threw that one on. The ticket is 5 furlongs on the grass. The 6 Frolicking Gallon second. This one from the Todd Fletcher barn. And also number 1, Bunny Breeze. We have a couple of horses together here. This kicks off the first of 2 pick 4s in the afternoon. And just looking at our selections, you know, you got to go a little deeper in there because it's a pretty wide open affair. And you know, basically first-time starters, you never know until they run.
I also think you have to use number 5, and that's Lovely, getting blinkers on for Jimmy Jerkins. Now, it's taken quite a bit of money in each of her 5 career starts. She's hit the board on 4 occasions. I think that you're probably going to have to use her in the second race on the day. We move on to the third race, which is a 12-5 maiden claiming event, 7 furlongs on the main track. And my top selection, Ron, your top selection, number 5, Amaluna. Second last time, got to the front, just got a little leg very late, but we're cutting back to 7/8 here.
And an old friend of ours that used to ride down here for a long, long time is in the saddle today, and that is Eddie Castro. Mm-hmm. So Eddie Castro is going to ride number 5, Amaluna. Little Jenny, I put in second, who's the number 4 horse, is dropping to this $12,500 level, stretching out slightly. Trouble trip last time out, got bumped at the 5/8 pole, finished the distance 5th, but it was again much better. 25,000 going 6.5 furlongs. Carlo Vaccarese is the trainer. Apprentice Tyler Gaffione, there's a guy, his apprentice. He's won about 6 or 7 races over the last, you know, couple of weeks. So he's starting to figure this game out, and that's apprentice Tyler Gaffione.
You mentioned Eddie Castro. Eddie Castro had a pretty good summer, actually, at Monmouth Park. He was in Saudi Arabia for a good part of the winter, and that's why we're seeing him back. But you're right. I was keyed in on that, too.
Yeah, I mean, he was a Florida regular for years and years.
We look on to the fourth race on today's card, and it is a 12-5 claiming event. It is 6 furlongs on the main track. And Ron, I love this one. It's Luca Bella sponsoring this race. Trainer of the month, Tom Albertani.
Oh, you got to love that, Tommy. A great guy and probably one of the nicest guys on the racetrack, and was having a real tough time, during the meet, finishing second like 11 times in a row, and then finally he broke out and had three wins on one day, and he finished second to a horse yesterday, and he said, "Ron, I'm back to doing it again." I said, "Don't worry about it. You'll move forward again." So a great guy.
Yeah, very good, great guy. So I went with number four in here, and that's a Builder Jack from the Giuseppe Di Sernia barn. Ron, last time Ran was coming, was running at a mile, now cutting back. I think the cutback's going to help. He's also, she's shown, she actually galloped in a January 15th race. But that was breaking her maiden.
Right.
So now facing winners, I still think numbers-wise, this is going to be one that is going to be one of the horses you want to...
You know, and speaking about jockeys that have been riding in great form over the last week or so, Luca Panici has had a bunch of winners, too. So these jockeys here, you got to keep in mind. I did go with that horse on top for all the reasons you mentioned. That's Builder Jack. But I used the number three, and you did, too, in second. Roxy Lucy moves to the next logical level, recovered from some trouble at the start. You know, got bumped around just a little bit, defeated $12,000 maidens by almost four lengths, but once again, there's another horse going up. I'm going to face winners after the maiden victory, and I close it out with Awesome America.
We look on to the fifth race on the card, and it is a 12.5 maiden claimer, 7 furlongs on the main track. We do have one jockey change. Number four, Lonesome Jay, will be ridden by Jonathan Gonzalez. And my top selection, it's a horse you didn't use, Ron, and that is the number 7, Starburst City. Now, the pedigree, Express Freedom, not particularly a known stallion, very few foals. It is a Florida, it's a Florida connection. This was my problem. I didn't, it's one of those races where you have a lot of these exposed types where I really didn't want to go in any one direction. I was torn between the 7 and the 2. I didn't end up going with the 7. I see a couple of decent works, including the latest, and I thought, you know, I was going to try to take a shot here. But number 2, Zoom Box, blinkers on for Charlie Asimakopoulos. I think that's going to, I think this is going to be the one that you have to look at.
Yeah, really. And that other horse that you got put on top, the number 7 in here, Starburst City, 15-1. So the horses you like to throw in, and when you're doing the pick four, you're right about the 2 Zoom Box, a recent gelding, now in the Charles Asimakopoulos barn. It's always hard for me to say the name. She could say it real well because she's Greek. Well, race with blinkers on, made the, making its first start since a pair of, you know, not too great a performance, 6th place finishes, but it was again similar. It was 3 months ago, and this barn has been doing good work with the limited amount of runners here, and I used the number 10, who you did too, I'm Sensational, and number 8, Diamonds and Gold, stretching out for Dave Paulus. Rafael Hernandez will be in the saddle.
Moving on to the 6th race on the card, and we do have an allowance optional claiming event, and it is $75,000 claiming tag, 7 furlongs on the main track, and it is, there's this one scratch, number 7, and that is Distinta. Ron, that didn't change my top selection. Number 4, Huasca. This was my top choice. Efren Loza Jr. is the trainer. Very consistent filly. She's hit the board in 4 of 5 career starts, including her latest, which was over this track in this distance.
Yeah, she was very game in defeat last time out. She dueled from start to finish. She was only beaten ahead. You mentioned the trainer, Johnny Velasquez. Johnny Velasquez, of course, the rider of Materiality yesterday, so won the Florida Derby. And then I used the number 1, who you did too. I used it in 2nd, used it in 3rd, and that's Moment of Delight. A multiple stakes place daughter of AP Warrior, who's beaten only a nose at this distance in the Susan Girls division of the Florida Science Stakes, makes her first start since finishing 2nd, going 2 turns. That was a 1 mile race course down at Gulfstream Park West in the Hut. This horse has got some nice back class. Trainer Bill Kaplan, his go-to jock Juan Leyva at the controls. You've got to use this horse on your ticket. I'm telling you that right now. This horse was, I liked this horse during the summer when it was in the Florida Sire Series.
And then there's a horse I use, Miss Wilby, and I think getting back, she was she ran in a stake last time, beaten by Taylor S. Taylor S., very nice filly from the Dale Romans barn as well. So I think her she's finding a little bit easier company here today. And also, I think the distance is going to suit just fine, too. So I think this is, I used number 2, and that is Miss Wilby. We'll take a short break, folks, and we'll come back and have a look at today's 7th race that kicks off the 20-cent Rainbow 6.
Gulfstream Park is one of Florida's top entertainment destinations, mixing restaurants, clubs, a casino, and international boutique shops with world-class racing. In a lavish, sun-drenched setting with the feel of a Mediterranean village, Gulfstream is a leading year-round entertainment and tourist destination, and the home of luxury residences in 2014. The Stronach family, owners of Gulfstream Park, is committed to the sport of thoroughbred racing and the grace, spirit, and generosity of the horse.
The Rainbow Six is back and it's better than ever. Now with a 20-cent base wager, it will expand the market for the popular bet. And in addition to doubling the base wager, the percentage return for the winners on the day the jackpot isn't hit increases to 70%, with 30% going to the carryover pool for the next program. Gulfstream Park, you got to be here each and every day.
Welcome back to Gulfstream Park, and we're going to have a look at today's seventh race that kicks off the 20-cent Rainbow Six.
$500,000 jackpot guarantee. That is reason to play it, and we'll see what happens with this. We had no singles yesterday, but a lot of people hit the six out of six, so we'll see if that can happen today. But somebody can take down $500 with just a 20-cent wager.
Well, we'll look at the seventh race, and Ron and I, we landed on the same horse, and that's number seven. Ricochet dropping from the 20,000 claiming company, Ron. That was last time, back on February 1st. I actually like this gelding. I usually watch him. I'm usually on him or involved somehow. he's usually somehow in my selections. He's just typically very, very consistent.
And he broke from a tough post last time out. He broke from post 12. He finished fourth. He was beaten three lengths. And as you mentioned, that was $20,000. Now $12,500. Before we talk about the next horse, you look at this race is named after, and it's the 2015 championship meet jockey, Javier Castellano. What a meet he has had.
Yeah, what a meet he's had. And he's still trucking, right?
Yeah. So it's not finished, but nobody can catch him. So that's why they're giving him the award today.
That's definitely for sure. So now Ricochet, he looks like he's going to be coming from just off, or he's going to be coming from off the pace. Ron, who else did you use?
Used the 9, Glenstall Abbey. There's another getting some class relief. He rallied from 15 lengths off the pace last time out to finish 30. He was beaten 1 3/4 lengths. That was against $20,000 three lifetime claimers. So getting some class relief. He closed really well in its last race. And then I used the number 5, Downtown, who could turn out to be a big part of the pace scenario if he can recapture that speed he was showing on the polytrack surface up at Woodbine. He might turn out to be a speed factor in there.
We look on to the eighth race on the card, which kicks off the Pick 5, and it is an allowance optional claiming event. It is a claiming price of $25,000, 1 mile on the turf course. And Ron, my top selection is number 6, and that is One More Strike. This is a daughter of the recently deceased Smart Strike. Smart Strike, such a tremendous stallion at Lane's End, and they put him down. He had laminitis. That is so sad, because he really was such a tremendous, not only such a tremendous racehorse, but also stallion. However, back to this filly, Brendan Walsh. He's been doing a great job here during this meet. Also, third last time, just beaten a half a length.
Yeah, 8-1 on the morning line, real good price. I want to go back and show your race, because the two horses that I pick in my top two selections, who you have on your ticket, the 3 and the 8, at Sea Trial and Achenaha, I think is how Larry pronounced it. You'll see them. They come back, and they both run very well in here, and I just wanted to replay this race to show you how well they ran in this particular thing. There is the 8 horse, is Sea Trial, and you'll see the number 10 horse here, Achenaha, closing strongly along the inside. I just thought it was a pretty good race for both of them, and that's why I used them 1-2 on the ticket. You see them closing at the wire, and you know, it just off that performance, I thought they needed to be put on my ticket here. But I'm gonna go back and look at your horse, number 6, One More Strike, one more time again, because you're absolutely right. Brendan Walsh had a great meeting, is having a great meeting.
We also have to say that the trainer of Sea Trial, and that is Shug McGahey, yesterday they landed the Pan American, and that was with Imagining. And how good is Shug? He's lethal. He's lethal in general, but on the turf, he's about 17% with his turf runner. So always something you've got to look at, and always something I think that you have to use among your selections. We move on to the 9th race on today's card, 16,000 claiming event. It is 1 1/16. On the turf course, and this race kicks off the late Pick 4, and we do have a few scratches in there, number 3, 9, and 10. And Ron, I went with number four. You went with number four. That is Kitten in May. Here's the token kitten.
Got to have your kitten horse on your ticket. And $100,000 will be in the guarantee in this late pick four. Kittens in May, you know the story. Mike Maker, Javier Castellano, turned back to a mile. This horse, eight starts in a mile, two wins in three thirds. I used the number. I went to the outside in here, and I like this horse a little bit. And that's El Chivo Viejo. We'll try to make it two in a row. He stretches out to a mile today after rallying. He was really impressive last time out. He rallied five wide in the turn to defeat $20,000 three lifetime claimants. George Navarro has Irod Ortiz Jr. in the saddle this afternoon. So I just thought that this horse can be somewhere on the ticket. And I used the five. It's like what you did, Overton Square, on my ticket from the Augustin Bazarabon.
Moving on to the 10th race on the card, and today's feature is the Sanibel Island Handicap. It is a mile on the turf course. There is one scratch, number seven, and that is Red Sachet. And Ron, I went with number four, and that is Isabella Singh. She's actually been pretty consistent other than that race over in California for the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies turf. When she really didn't show up, she made a move and flattened out there. I think she's actually just shown a very good form. And we will take a look back at her most recent victory. That was back on February 26th. We're watching her right now. She's in on the rail. And by the way, the filly on the two are outside, Ron. She's a very, very nice filly, Ice Festival, a nice Stronach runner. Pretty nice filly.
Yeah, and this is a great performance by Isabella Singh. She's going to try and make it two in a row after this really nice performance. Mentioned did not come up big in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile Fillies Turf, but the very good performance. Looks like the one to beat in there. Three all in front. It's heading back to the turf after highlighting her versatility. She followed her maiden win on the Belmont Turf. Then she comes back and she wins in handy fashion, a $75,000 optional claimer here in the slop. Shug McGee, there you go, man. Javier Castellano. And how about Miss Margaret? I like Miss Margaret. This horse is pretty game. I got to believe you got to have her somewhere on your late pick four ticket.
Yeah, she's so consistent.
Yeah,
she always
really
just seems to run a race. And we move on to the 11th race on today's card, and it is an allowance optional claiming event. It is a claiming tag, $100,000, a mile of 16th on the turf course. And we do have one scratch, number seven, and that is Iron Power. And my top pick, Ron, I went with the number eight, and that is Middleburg. This is a five-year-old son of Lemon Drop Kid. Look at Christoph Clement and John Velasquez, when they combine, doesn't happen all that often, but when it does, they're almost at a 45% clip. And Middleburg has just been the model of consistency, broke through with a victory last time. That was back in November. And I just think that this is going to be one of the horses you got to watch.
You got to watch this horse. So I want to go back and show you the performance of today. It's the three horses, Amen Kitten. This is a great one, Stakes Place, Son of Kitten's Joy. There's my other kitten horse today. This was one fantastic race where Miss Showers just gets through at the end to win this race. But you'll watch number two, Amen Kitten, just keeps coming and coming. This is a grade one event with grade one horses in it. And she comes back and she's going to run in this optional claimer allowance, $100,000. I just think she's got a lot of class, and she's going to run well in there. Middleburg, of course, you got to use. And we both used the four tricky hat because it's Shug McGee and Javier Castellano.
You mentioned Amen Kitten, that race. If you look who was third that day, it was War Correspondent.
Who came back and won, yeah.
And just won yesterday, won a stake here yesterday. So very, very salty field last time, and that was in the Gulfstream Park Turf Handicap. We move on to the 12th and final race on today's card, and it is a 20,000 maiden claiming event, 7.5 furlongs on the turf course. We do have one scratch, number two, and Ron, we both went to the outside. That's number 13, Gold Piece. Not particularly fond of the post position, to tell you the truth, especially at the 7.5. But I really thought there were two horses in here for me, the 13 and the 3, and that's just the way I decided
to go. Yeah, and we went the same way in there for all the reasons. You know, 20 barn of the 13, the 20% with new claims. That's Mike Petro, famous Sting. We'll race with the blinkers off today. And then I used the number 8. We're exact agreement here with the number 8, that these Causeway. So that wraps up our 12 race card. And you know, before I sign off in here, we're going to show you the Pan African. But before I want to sign off, this is our last handicapping show for a while. So we're not going to be back on the air maybe until the next championship meet. We'll see how that works out. absolute pleasure working with you. As you know, we had a ball doing it all year long. I'll still be here. I'm always here, it seems like. Christina will be on to bigger and greater things. And guess what else? We got our old buddy back today, Pete Aiello. He'll be calling the races throughout our summer campaign. Yeah. He'll give you all the scratches and updates you need. So it has been a pleasure. And what better way to end it with a good race?
Ron's going to get all weepy. Isn't that awesome? Yes, it has been. It has been a really tremendous race and a tremendous season. And also, what can we say? What a great Florida Derby day that we had. But, Ron, it's been good.
Been good.
We got one more day to go, though, folks. You haven't got rid of me yet. We're going to send you off taking a look back. Actually, we were just talking about it at yesterday's Pan American Imagining from the Shug McGahee Barn. Just ran lights out. What a tremendous performance from Imagining. Good luck, folks.
And they come to the top of the stretch together. Twilight Eclipse and Imagining, and nothing separates them. They come into the final furlong side by side. Imagining on the outside. Twilight Eclipse along the rail. Imagining's in front. Twilight Eclipse can't go with them. Late move on the outside from Pyrite Mountain, who's trying to get into the mix. But Imagining has won it.
Point of entry would not be denied. And they're into the stretch.
Point of entry's taking the lead.
Point of entry, a two-length lead.
It's point of entry taking the lead.
Point of entry will go to the Breeders' Cup
on a five-race winning streak.
Five-time Grade 1 winner from a deep Phipps family. With the pedigree and physical to become the heir of Dinah Former. Point of entry. Standing at Adina Springs.